There's not much to see in northern Sweden apart from a heck of a lot of snow, the occasional moose, and just potentially the electric future of the hot hatchback. So yeah, while I think some very warm thoughts, here's the backstory.
You might remember last summer, I went to a test track in Germany and drove two Hyundai concept cars. They were designed to show how exciting speed machines will live on after the petrol engine dies. One was the stunning hydrogen fuel cell Envision 74, and the other was an all-electric touring car testbed called the RN22E. It used two electric motors to generate 577 horsepower, had an internal speaker to synthesize engine noise, and even featured artificial flappy paddle gear shifts. It was a brainstorm on wheels, looking for ways Hyundai's N division could make electric cars that do more than just win drag races.
Oh, that looks warm. So, fast forward to spring 2023, and here is the next stage of the story, the prototype for the Hyundai Ioniq 5 N. So this is, to a normal Ioniq 5, what a Golf R is to a normal Golf. This is more powerful, it's much faster, and it's much angrier looking underneath this disguise. But it's not out here in winter wonderland just to find out how quickly the battery drains when it's cold enough to freeze your eyelids shut. No, they're out here testing and training this thing's electronic sense of humor, the gadgets that will perhaps maybe make you want to swap your hot Golf for a hot Hyundai. Right, speaking of heat, I'm gonna get in the warm just once I get off the ice.
The first bit of N cleverness is something called the N Drift Optimizer, and that's a driving mode dedicated to easy power sliding. But apparently it's much more than just bugging all the power to the back and sending the traction control on a T-brake.
Oh no, the N Drift Optimizer also fiddles with your steering weight, it recalibrates the adaptive suspension and optimizes the electronic limited slip diff. Basically, it's millions and millions of lines of computer code designed to make a very new, modern electric car misbehave like an old rally car. So, here's my rally hat. Right, let's go rallying.
This prototype isn't showroom ready yet, but Hyundai said I could take it out onto the ice and see where they're up to.
Now listen, I'm old school, right? I'm from the 1990s. So to me, a hot hatch has 200, maybe 250 horsepower. It sends all of that to the front wheels. And if you want to kick the tail out, then you had to yank the handbrake. But this supposedly is the future, and that means 600 horsepower, 2 tons of weight, and engineers working round the clock in places like this to basically allow you to power slide, well, as long as your lunch can hold out. So we're now in the N Drift Optimizer mode. You have to go into the touchscreen to set it up, and I'm not allowed to show you that. Like, I'm not allowed to show you lots of things inside this car. I'm not allowed to tell you about the new, quite thick steering wheel with its paddles and its N mode buttons on it. Can't tell you about that. Or I can't tell you about these rather excellent N seats. Yes, you sit higher than a normal hot hatch, but you sit lower than a normal Ioniq 5, so I like that. Can't tell you about the N pedals, can't tell you about all of the different graphics going on in here. But like I say, I've been fiddling with it and I've set the drift mode up. What I've not set up is my brain to react as quickly as you need to work with electric motors delivering the torque. We all know that in a petrol engine car, whether it's normally aspirated or turbocharged, there's a peak to the power delivery. You can kind of anticipate it. But with an electric motor, it's absolutely instant and you have to be lightning fast to catch it. Now, the drift mode does sort of cater to that. It says, look, I know that not all of you are gonna be rally champions, certainly not. So it is helping direct the power to the front motor when you are getting it really wrong, if you're fully broadside, if you absolutely clog the throttle, it will just about track you straight. But you might be able to see about the steering effort I'm putting in. You've got to be awake to it. Well, on an ice lake anyway, which is of course the absolute most relevant test for an electric car. I don't know about you, but I do find it hilarious as well how much time and money has been spent on what I call Yobomatic technology over the past few years. I think maybe Ford kicked it off putting line lock in the Mustang so anyone could do a perfect burnout. Then the BMW M2 had smoky burnout mode. AMG put drift mode in just about everything. And even Ferrari, well, they've perfected side slip angle control, so even an absolute wally like me feels like a superhero as they power slide around in a 296. Human beings are just a weird species, aren't we? We've spent so much time and effort all these years making cars safer and stronger and much, much better at looking after you should the worst happen. And now the cleverest people with the cleverest laptops in the world are spending their days in winter wonderland teaching cars to misbehave. Sideways. There are people paid to teach cars to do this. Is that going round? No. Nah, you see, it's clever, the drift mode. Just imagine what this is going to do to your tyres when you are not on a polished bit of frozen pond. Over 2 tons, this thing, 600 horsepower, probably 600 pounds feet of torque as well. It is going to eat Pirellis.
Now, as you can see, I'm enjoying my guilt-free slides, but what's nagging away at me is this. There is no electric car currently on sale where the version you want to buy is the really fast one. Doesn't matter if it's a Mustang Mach-E GT, Porsche Taycan Turbo S, Polestar Performance Pack, spending top money on the top model means you go from 0 to 60 a bit quicker, but you tend to sacrifice a load of range in the process. And right now, with lithium battery tech suffering in cold weather and pretty dodgy public charging infrastructure, the novelty of terrifying acceleration tends to wear off faster than reassuring range does. I mean, give me a long range Tesla Model 3 over a Model 3 Performance any day of the week.
Look, as you can see, I'm grinning, and I do have boundless respect for what the Hyundai engineers are up to in trying to bring old school giggles to new school cars. But I just have this sneaking suspicion that while the conversation around EVs is still so much about range and about the dodgy charging infrastructure, I just can't help thinking, are there that many people who, when it comes to paying their 60, 70,000 pounds, are they truly going to prioritise getting sideways over getting home? Oh, that's gone. That's gone. And it's up the snowbank. Oh, no. And it's stuck. I'm not a rally driver. Okay, we might use that as a bit of an outtake, but I am genuinely stuck. Where's the tow truck? I am just going to make a quick racing driver excuse. The reason that I span off there was not just my complete lack of talent. It's that this prototype was supposed to have the N-generated sounds that you might remember from that RN22E that I drove last year. That's basically the great big speaker hanging off the back and simulating engine noise, which, okay, is fake, and you might argue it's there just for showing off. But the engineers are saying that actually that helps you when you're power sliding because you can hear where the revs are, and that means you know when you're kind of overcooking it. So there you go. If this prototype had the sound generation working, I might not have just binned this into part of Sweden. Definitely.
course, what we could really do with at this point is a chat with someone who knows inside out what people who buy fast cars really want. Someone like the ex-BMW M Division boss and now figurehead of Hyundai's N Division, Albert Biermann. He's the German mastermind of the sensational i20N and i30N hot hatches and Kia's big friendly Stinger GT sports saloon. So, does the big man really think the world is ready for hot hatch EVs?
Albert, thank you very much for your time. Could you just explain as quickly as possible, why is it important to you that an N car, even an electric N car, can drift?
Well, on an N car, the fun to drive, the playfulness, and the emotional driving experience is absolutely number one priority. And now we have a change in vehicle concept from front wheel drive to all wheel drive. So now we have a driven rear axle, and of course, it would be a shame not to utilize drifting and power slides.
Yeah. I mean, you're on the record, I think we've spoken before, where you've said that some car makers perhaps have chased straight line speed with EVs with acceleration too much. But the Ioniq 5N has a huge amount of power, nearly perhaps 600 horsepower. Do you think we'll see EV power outputs come down a little bit, or do you think they're always going to be very high while the cars are so heavy?
I think the race for more and more EV power has just started. It will go pretty crazy. I'm pretty sure about that. So
where can it go from here? We're already cars with 1,000 of horsepower.
This is not so easy. Not a big challenge to do, to put 1,000 horsepower in an EV. Right? It's no big deal. But that doesn't make a high-performance car.
And just on that as well, the N cars we've really loved, the i20N recently, that was the Top Gear car of the year, the Veloster N, which we don't get in the UK, but I know it's done really well in the US, Kona N's crazy. These are all small cars. The Ioniq 5N is naturally bigger. I know you have to package a bigger battery and everything, but how far do you think we're away from being able to have a small electric performance car? Or is everything naturally just going to be a size bigger now?
No, I think, as you know, we do N cars based on our regular mass production cars. The time will come, we will have smaller EVs. And then when we have smaller EVs, of course, we can do an N EV on a smaller base model.
What would be like your message to someone who would be considering an EV, why they should go for the fast version? Why would they not just be sensible and go for the car with the number range?
And when we launch Ioniq 5N, the difference in range will not be that huge. Ioniq 5N will have a bigger battery capacity.
Not compensate.
Not a bigger battery, but it has already next generation battery technology. So, and of course, we might still be a little bit behind the base Ioniq 5 all-wheel drive car. But even here, when we drove the car all weekend out there on the winter roads here, minus 10 degrees, it was amazing how efficient the car was, even with the cold temperature situation on winter tires. So I'm not so pessimistic about range on the Ioniq 5N.
It's fine. So I look forward to driving the finished car. Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you for coming. Cheers.
Now, to be fair, the Ioniq 5N is not actually finished yet. That's why it's still wearing its pajama onesie. But what I have been impressed by today is the lengths that Hyundai is going to give this thing its own personality. This is not going to be another EV flagship that looks the same as all of its brethren and just goes a bit faster in a straight line. So we'll find out later on in the year if that personality, that character they're trying to inject into this is, well, your cup of tea. Oh, cup of tea.